Hello again, everyone. Todd Struch, the horror nerd, here at Scares the Care Charity Weekend 7 down in beautiful Williamsburg, Virginia. Things are getting rolling here on the first day of the convention, Friday night. I have the honor of standing here with the star of one of my favorite films growing up, The Hidden, Mr. Ed O. Ross. Ed, how are you today?
I'm good. Thank you.
Good. How are you enjoying the convention so far?
You know, it's a very unique experience because, as I said to you before, I haven't done that many of these. And to see all the people here and see the reaction from the crowd, I think really holds true in terms of why they're here, in terms of scares that care.
Right.
And when you start to say to yourself, hey, look, you know, I'm doing this for a charity event, and it really means something. And if I can deal with it, and if I can make it happen so that they can make money on it and help people out, I'm here.
Good, man. Good, and we're happy to have you.
Yeah.
We truly appreciate the
you coming out. When Joe and Dominic Mancini asked me to come down and do it, I said, well, you know, fine, you know, I'll be more than happy to do it, because a lot of times you don't really realize how many people know you, you know, or how many people recognize, like, some of the great films, like Full Metal Jacket, Action Jackson, and some of the even the films like Dick Tracy. You know, I mean, there's just some wonderful things there, and if that can translate into helping this charity, I'm all for it.
Fantastic. Thank you so much
for
being here. You know, now, you know, obviously, you know, I think you're probably most well known for The Hidden, and I love that movie.
Yeah.
But you just mentioned Dick Tracy.
Yeah.
I have a huge affinity for that movie. I really do. I know it has its, you know, detractors, but I happen to love it because it really is, seems like all of you stepped right off the comic book page with the makeups and the costumes and everything. Tell me a little bit about that experience. How much fun was it to do that movie?
What's really interesting about it is that we had guys like Shel Dorff, who was one of the creators. We had Gould, who wrote the comics and put us in the funny papers, which is really cool.
Mm.
And my character, Itchy, I took on a different kind of voice and a different kind of character for it. It was really interesting because it was 3 hours of makeup every morning.
Wow.
and you know, with the nose and the lips and everything, and it's like, wow, that was really getting tough for a while.
Mm.
But to work with all the great actors, I was working with Al Pacino, I was working with Dustin Hoffman.
Right.
I was working with Warren Beatty, I was working with Madonna. I mean, how lucky can you get?
Right?
You know?
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, like I said, I love that movie, and just the, like you said, the sheer number of big time actors that were in it. People sometimes, I think, don't realize that.
Yeah, they don't. A lot of times, people also too, because of the makeup, a lot of people didn't know who was who.
Mm.
And a lot of times, people will get with, like, you know, they knew Al and they knew these guys, but when you start to really investigate that movie, you see great act R.G. Armstrong.
Mm.
Okay, Henry Silva. I mean, you're talking about iconic guys. Henry Silva was in, you know, the Manchurian Candidate with Sinatra. I mean, you know, it's like, whoa, you know, you're talking about iconic people. And, you know, you're blessed to be in that movie. I was really blessed for that.
I wish they had done another one, but I guess it just wasn't meant to be.
Well, yeah, I guess.
So, and just to very quickly, Ed, I don't want to keep you, you know.
No.
Again, another one of my favorite movies, Full Metal Jacket.
Yeah, great
and
film.
That is a great film, and that is an intense film. What was it like being involved in that production?
You know, it was amazing because what we did was... I figured I'd just go over there for like 2 weeks and come back home and that would be the end of it.
Mm.
Well, it was like, you know, 7 months later, you know. But what was even more interesting than that, it was like the aftermath of that. A friend of mine, as a matter of fact, I was just talking to Brett about it. A friend of mine introduced me to the guy who I played in the film.
Oh, no kidding.
And he was the original combat photographer and journalist. His name is Bob Bayer, B-A-Y-E-R. And Bob and I have since become friends, and we talked and chatted and you know, exchanged photographs. My photographs are of like the film business.
Right.
His photographs are of the real thing.
Wow. I
mean, they're amazing. They're absolutely amazing.
Wow.
And to have that kind of experience outside of it is wonderful. But then again, when you start to look at Full Metal Jacket, the first guy you look at is Stanley Kubrick.
Sure.
And working with a genius like Stanley, you learn so much. You learn so much. And I mean, the other guys were great. You know, Matthew Modine, my buddy Adam Baldwin. I still play golf with Adam. Nice people. Wonderful time. They were there longer than I was.
Mm-hmm.
But the one thing I'm very proud of is that the one scene that we did was like this big scene where we were walking down the path and there's like helicopters and tanks and tons of money they spent on the scene. And Stanley was always known for doing like 4, 5, 6, 7 takes, 20 takes. We shot that whole scene in one take.
Wow.
And I'm really proud of that.
That's amazing. Yeah, that's amazing. Like you said, for Kubrick, that's an accomplishment.
Yeah, exactly. I'm happy
about that. Very cool. So, Ed, one last question. What are you up to these days? What keeps you busy?
What happens right now is I'm writing a book on the acting in the industry, and I'm also promoting a film that I had written called The Garlic Cafe. And hopefully we're into, like, kind of negotiations and trying to get it around, trying to get somebody to say, okay, here's the money, go direct it and have a good time.
Great.
And it's basically about three savants that take a piece of a ramshackle place and turn it into a paradise, and a lot of the townspeople don't like that.
Ah, gotcha.
You know, so it's kind of an interesting deal. It is.
Sounds interesting.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun.
Ed, before we wrap up, any final words to the fans about Scares the Care and the convention?
The only thing I can tell you people is honestly, look them up on the internet if you don't believe me or if you think I'm promoting this. This is a very, very worthwhile charity. Whenever somebody can help somebody who is in need and they have a child that is hurting, you parents out there, you know what it's like. Give, support this charity, make Joe happy, and make those people happy, because that's really where it's at. I wouldn't be here if I didn't believe in his charity.
Kind words from Ed O'Ross. Ed, thank you so much for a few minutes of your time.
Thank you.
I truly appreciate it. I wish you much success in everything that you do.
God bless.
And have a great rest of the weekend here at the convention. Ed O'Ross, everybody, here at Scares the Care Charity Weekend 7, Williamsburg, Virginia. Horror Nerd signing off. We will see all of you in the next interview.